Some water's still running through there, isn't it?
Yeah. come in.
You gotta open it.
You're coming.
There's a crash in the head.
Sure thing's running?
What?
That thing.
Yes. Close the door. That something? Sure looks like it. Do what, Jack?
They're gonna go ahead and stick ties on this too, and then what we want to do is.
We can, yeah.
Check around and see what I can find. What do you assume? You know, if I have to get Miller's, I can get a crap.
Okay.
I'll tell Bill to have him check it.
those trains, the airport and everything was on the front page of the New York Times yesterday, according to Max. Get around here and get a look at the railroad now. Yeah, that's what's going to make everybody happy. I'm not at all happy with myself. Look at that. That is the dead dumbest mess you ever did see. First large location, looking back east towards St. Joe, Mothos 4.34. The switch you see goes into the BMS warehouse where the NEKM had their first office building. This once again is the 4.34 location looking back west toward Wathena. This location is 8 or 9 rail lengths long. probably a 10 to 12 foot hole. See a battery box there for the flasher?
30's highway.
Pretty severe washout. Take a little while to fix. Water was running through this area probably 8 or 9 days, 6 to 8 feet above the existing rail. Just east of the BMS switch, 4.25, there's a BMS building. One of our customers, Galt Packaging, is in there. The water in that building was 4 feet deep. They pretty much recovered from the flood as far as
back in operation goes.
There's a lot of cleanup yet to do. We'll proceed on east here, showing you various spots until we get up in the two and three mile, and we'll get a little higher view of this. Location here, about 4.22, still going east. This is right across from the BMS warehouse. Numerous locations. Most of them are a little larger than this one, 2 to 4, 6 feet deep, as we proceed on east towards the city of Elwood. Another location, 4.20, small hole, there's two of them. Damage would have been more severe here if it wasn't for this large building being in the way of the water and forced it pretty much around this area right here. You can see all this ballast out toward the property line. Another location, about 4.15, rail and a half so long, a couple feet deep. About the last one that we crossed the Apple Orchard Road. Still, we're continuing east. Here at 4.1, looking east, you can see there's numerous washouts onto the east. Probably 7 or 8 before we get up along the old highway here that runs adjacent to the track. Basically, all of them are the same. 2 to 4 rail lengths, 2, 4, 6 feet deep. Typical washouts for this area. Another location, still heading east, right around the milepost 4. Two and a half, 3 rail lengths long. About 3.9, still looking east. A couple of 3 small ones here in a row. Right next to these bean fields, and there was a home, apple orchard. All this in through here had up to 12 feet of water, covering the railroad and all this property for several days. It was very devastating to the live in these homes and all these property owners, as well as the railroad. We're at about 3.75, right in that area, still looking east. As we progress east, you get into the more severely damaged areas where there was more flow, swift current, really wide open spaces, and it did quite a bit more damage where there wasn't anything obstructing its flow. Mm-hmm. 3.70, still looking east. This is where we break out behind the orchard and these homes and get out into the wide open area now, you can see all the trash and debris washed up on the railroad. This spot here is probably 10, 12 feet deep, 2 or 3 railings long. Pretty nasty little spot. The area right in here is 3.68, 67. A little short washout. Several of them up through here like this. Another small one there, still looking east. You can see we're a mile or so out of Elwood proper. It's pretty much still farming. A few houses. To our left over here will be Rosecrans Airport. This area right in here is pretty shallow as far as being washed out, but all the ballast is gone. It's quite a few ties are missing. Not gonna be too difficult to fix. It's a little time consuming. Get rid of all this debris and all that kind of stuff. It's fairly long. Wouldn't expect anything like this. Leastwise, I didn't. Coming up on a 3.5. Still a few little short washouts. A lot of trash. We've had a lot of heavy rain the last few days. You can see all that water standing in those fields out there. Spot right here that a lot of trash just about knocked all the ties off when it banged up against the railroad and kind of hung up there. We're going to be coming up on the very first one of three of the worst washouts of the bunch. It's pretty nasty when it's not as long as the other two, but it is be quite a challenge. This whole water and what to do with the railroad when you're trying to fix it. About 3.40. You can see the ballast is all chewed away, shoulder fill, railroad's kind of just hanging up there in the air. If we go a little further here, we're going to see it where the water actually cut through. There's about 5 rail lengths of that shoulder and fill cut away pretty bad. Here we get into the railroad hanging in about 11 or 12 rail lengths of track that's kind of suspended there, kind of like a swing bridge. Fairly deep, probably 20-25 feet or so from grade or where it really belongs. It's going to be a little while to fix it and quite a bit of material to fill up this hole. As you can see, most of our fill material for the most part is mixed in with so much dirt it's not reusable, or it's plumb gone from the force of the water. Just pretty much took it and done whatever it wanted to with it. Looking back west on this location, about 3.40, kind of give you a different view of it. This is Rosecrans Airport, kind of an industrial type airport for St. Joe, as well as an air guard base there. Very heavily damaged. It just it's come through there and tore up everything like it did everywhere else. About 3.20, the second of the three large washouts. This one here is fairly long. We estimate 2,000 feet where it really begins to kind of where it quits. Sorry about this jumping around so, but it's not a very good other way to get a picture of it without getting up a little higher. This is probably going to be the toughest one to fix due to the fact it's wet and just a lot of distance. As you can see, there's water everywhere you look around us. These old lakes and whatnot. these areas of this water was where the 52 flood come through. And this was the Missouri River at one day in time on the other side of those piling driven out there. And there's another picture of the airport. Tremendous amount of water come through here. Just unbelievable. Looking back west on that same location, about 3.25. That area right where that bulldozer is sitting in that muddy area in the road is all, there's a big hole in the road where the water come through. And you can see the thing's got quite a bit of distance to it. You can see it rocking and rolling down through there. Some more of that same area. Looking back west, there was a kind of little county dirt road. Got washed away. We can see this location continues on east here. It's
car coming.
Compost 3 right there, laying on the ground. Just looking east of Compost 3 on towards St. Joe here. Dadgummit. Track here is all out of alignment. It's shoved over in the brush there. It's probably 15 feet in some places from center line where it belongs. Quite a bit of debris up against it. As we go on down toward 2.5, toward airport crossing, just numerous small washouts, typical of what we've already seen. We'll see a couple more locations and then we'll go uptown Elwood and the 1.5 in that area up there and look at the rest of it. .5 area here. Getting back into where the washouts are going to be more spotty due to the fact we're in a populated area again. The flow is obstructed by buildings and houses and trees. And first one thing and another, they're pretty spotty. Coming up on Airport Road. Two or three small washouts in this area. See the signal case there, that 3 or 4 feet up on where that difference in the color of the paint, that's where the water line stood for several days. It was higher than that at one point, but it stood to that line for several days. We go on across this crossing, there's a washout or two over there. So,
come back your feet to that dead dirt.
West end of the Elwood Yard to run around. Goes into Elwood Warehouse, which we do some business in there, cans and paper, food, dog food that is. You can see we had a couple of boxcars in there for loading, and they were about half loaded at the time of the flood. They've now unloaded them. Water was up into the product. Two of them there. Getting up close to the main yard at Elwood, the 7 or 8 rail links here washed out 4 and 5 feet deep, washed out in a couple of switches, not too severe. Dog houses are plenty and kids' little riding toys. We can see everything that wasn't nailed down. over at the east end of Elwood Yard, 1.25. Main line just kind of washed out in spots and just looks like a washboard. The 3 yard tracks are basically need some ballast. The tie condition's pretty good shape. Far track over goes into Wayne Feed. Big elevators, just a little ballast in places. The track structure's in good shape. East towards St. Joe here, we got the third of the three spots that's damaged the worst. The track you can see is all washed to one side, completely washed out. Very good shape. Got a big pool of water here to deal with, and working closely with the city and the Corps on this. Still here at the east end of Elwood. Where the yard industry comes back into the main track, it's all pretty well washed out. Of course, there's no big holes, you know, they all be repaired fairly easily. More so than in places with the big deep holes and so on. Not good, but it's better than some. This area right here is going to be of a big concern, I think, to everybody. Take quite a few yards of ballast or riprap to fill this hole up, but pretty deep. Not so long, but it's deep. Here we are up at milepost 1, or 1.5. You can see the tremendous amount of water coming through here. It just destroyed homes. And This hole of water is fairly deep in places. Fortunately, none of the railroad over there is only 4 or 5 feet deep. See Herzog Contracting in the background over there, just now getting the asphalt plant back online. Milepost 1 looking towards St. Joe Bridge. Track's not in too bad shape for very far that away, just a couple hundred yards. Vermont Street crossing right here, it's all washed out, the street, everything. It's flashers and signals, all that are pretty well gone here. Looking back west on this big hole at 1.5, it looks really worse than it is, even though it is a fairly large hole. The city's done a lot to fill it in so far, and it's going to take some material. Another look at Vermont Street here. Only one flasher left standing. Yesterday morning, Milepost 7.1. Depends on who you talk to, 6 to 10 inch rain in an extremely short amount of time. Took out large trees out of the riverbank. The river was up to